I'm sure everybody's hungry by now, but and what we've done is basically what they have done would probably make you hungrier. So what we've done is basically the course was sustainability, but being a product designer and expected to design products, we felt that we should talk about our memories, how we can sustain our memories. And sustain our memories through food, or what we remember, because as a kid, I grew up in a small town, and there the food was all wrapped in leaves, mostly. It was a hill station in the north, and especially the sweet, which was called SINGORI, which was wrapped in a leaf, a local leaf, gave a kind of fragrance to the sweet, which I still remember. I haven't eaten for 20 years, and I now live in Singapore, where everything comes from outside. It's all packed, it's all barcoded, and there's so much of waste, but it's a clean city. So where does that mess that we see here in India goes? Here everybody is honest and they throw it on the street. And somebody picks it up and recycles it, but there's landfills. Everything's cleaned every morning. The landfills, and you don't even know if the land that they have is enough for the consumption that's taking place. So to us, it was not about designing a new packaging. It's about living with our memories, trying to recreate no packaging. And we thought, if there's no packaging, let's only talk about the food. So here we are. So to me, it was fragrance of the food. So it was fragrance, convergence of fragrance, fragrance when you converge. And this convergence is what we follow. Some of the people have gone, they were probably too hungry and they couldn't wait. This is a student who actually thought about playing with paper in his class. That was his memory. And he thought of eating bhakarwadi, which is a Gujarati snack. And he made this graphics. He said he's confused, but I'm sure he was hungry. And he remembered the fragrance of bhakarwadi. So he said recycle. So he said we shouldn't have plastic and we should have paper bag. The idea was not to make a product. The idea was also not to give slogans and to make more messages, but just to enjoy, like we enjoy eating food, to enjoy the process of drawing, of putting it as a poster, as a visual.
Hi. I'm a Bengali, and when I was a kid, my mom used to make this dish called dab chingri. Dab in Bengali means green coconut, and chingri means prawn. So that's the image of the dish. And what you basically do is cook the chingri or the prawn in the dab itself, in the coconut. So you add your spices, etc., and put it in the pressure cooker or your microwave right now, and it cooks. And it takes really long. It takes about an hour and a half, but it's really delicious. So you all should try it. And I was just thinking, I mean, why not introduce it locally? You know, I mean, why should you go to a restaurant? Why should you go to a Bengali household to eat this? Okay, so I was thinking, why not introduce it locally? So that was my idea. I haven't made a product exactly. Maybe y'all could come up with it. I'm just trying to get y'all aware of it. And so this is my visual. I've called this visual poster a cul-de-sac. I'm doing my architecture. So we deal, I think Corbusier, if I'm not wrong, came up with this system of a road where you go straight, you can't go ahead. You loop and you come back. Right? So I'm just trying to say that we have our tradition, and let's not forget it. We are on a path, and let's loop and turn back to where we were. So yeah, basically, and the barcode symbolizes supermarket, mass production, etc. today. So simply, that's it.
I'll add to that, the barcode is intentional because these roadside hawkers and vendors actually going out of business because of the packed products which are cheaper in the supermarket. So if we try and say global issue, local design or local, we have to sustain these people, and if they create things with passion, with their own history, then people, they'll get customers, young customers. Also, I'll add one thing. The food was for young people, people who go to McDonald's, people who use a lot of waste. So it was basically to bring them back to these small hawkers. So the idea was not to create things with passion, cook with passion, serve with passion without the ugliness that you see around it, including, if I may add, the way the food was served here at IDC, which was really ugly sight very often. The way it was thrown onto your plate, I think we have to care, we have to be careful, we have to really respect what we do. And this was really in my back of my mind when we were discussing in the class.
So this is sustainable sticks. Before I start up, I just want to show up an equation, and this is to all Indians. We all go to Indian marriages, all right? So we go there like hungry for the very first sweet that we come across, which is the laddu wrapper. And laddu is kind of thing that has been wrapped in a small piece of paper. Now, just going through an equation, like if we calculate what is the area of this wrapper, it's 2 centimeters, and then with pi r square goes about 12 centimeters square. And if we just calculate how many people go around in a wedding, it's around 1,000. So 1,000 wrappers per 1,000 wedding. So 1,000 wrappers calculate up to 12,000 centimeter squares of page used. And according to a legal letter size paper size, it's around 616 centimeter squares. So if we divide it, so it comes around to say 20 letter sizes paper that are be used for one wedding. So if we calculate about the ever-growing, ever-rising population of India that marries about 1 crore people in a year, so it calculates up to 20 crore or so added the number of papers being used. And if one cord wood produces around 61,92,000 around of papers, and if you divide it, you get around 35 cord of trees being wasted 1 year. Now, can you imagine, like, Indians waste just 35 trees? That is not just 35 trees a year just on that laddu wrapper. Now, this is like a big equation. So this is just an equation for wrapper. If you talk about other things like the weight that comes under weight wastage, which is the paper napkins, which are the things that come on the candy wrappers. So this can be recycled. So I did a literature survey on this and found that the confectionery industry in this world is like the key industry for the product packaging as well as the packaging groups on a global scale. And one of the industries around the world is the Chessbook, which primarily has one of the innovative ideas that have been rolling around the globe. And that idea is basically having new and innovative solutions to use different kind of sustainable material or as well as a recyclable material for candies, wrappers and sweets. So I just went around doing some different innovative ideas to just wrap up this base of the sweet into a stick and then added a different kind of forms and concepts to the sticks. So ultimately this becomes a sustainable sticks that avoids wrapper, which is a wastage.
Adding on to this, what we also discussed was using materials which are recyclable. But when we use recyclable materials like glass or any other metal, we found out that when we use them for eating or serving, we need to wash them every time, and of water that we waste using washing those materials. So instead of using those materials, we can use materials which we can throw, just like we used leaves many years ago, or like we use wood, maybe a bamboo, small bamboo, to serve the foods, or maybe serving foods on using leaves as wrappers and directly throw it away. Then we save a lot of water washing those plates and everything, and that's a big amount.
Hello everybody. Now, like, for everyone who don't know about this, this is a very common Indian dish. It is called a samosa. It is like very readily available at every corner of the street. So now my idea behind this was, whenever you get a samosa, you either get it in some plastic plate or either you get it in some steel utensil. Anyways, you're causing harm to environment because you wash the steel plates and you throw the plastic plates. So my idea was, you know, when you are done eating, you eat up the plate and you give away zero waste. So it is like you eat the samosa, eat the plate, and then wash up your hands and just leave the place.
Based on the similar concept, in India, we primarily eat with our hands, and our food doesn't look that appealing to the younger generation. I mean, like dal chawal or sabzi with the plain rotis. So our attempt was to make something trendy and appealing to the younger generation, and also have it in a bite size, which you don't get a huge thali with plate and have different vegetables which you end up wasting or leaving a piece of the roti. You get small, nice pack. Or roti cones or something like this. This is just an image to explain a concept. It's not yet a product, but just the wrapper which you can eat. I mean, the food which is wrapped and you can eat the wrapper itself. And that was the idea behind this. You see, it's all vegetarian and non-vegetarian stuff. And you can serve it in something like that. Keep it on a table, a few college friends go and they hang around with it and keep it in the center and pick up whichever they like. And you know, something trendy and nice to compete with what the pizzas and the burgers we order usually, with a whole lot of packaging. And another thing was, you eat what you make then and there. It's fresh, you get it there, and you finish it off. So you don't really pack, wash, use plates, and again get back to eating with your hand. So that was the concept behind this.
This is Puri Sevpuri. Sevpuri, as most of us know, is one of the favorite snacks that we have. And for people who don't know about Sevpuri, it's a kind of nachos with toppings on it. So what I came up with the product was, instead of using a separate plate to serve Sevpuri, why not have the puri or the papadi that we have as a small plate that the person will give to the customers in their hand, and they just eat it and quickly eat and leave. So this is a small combination of three puris at a time, and you just break one at a time and eat and leave. So that is Puri Sevpuri. Puri in Hindi means whole, and the second puri means the papadi or the nachos.
Hi. Actually, for me, sustainability means a relationship with the earth. So, relationship reminds me our relationships with anybody. We greet others by giving sweets. So, I thought of a package which will be eatable. Packaging of sweet which is eatable. So, this is a surprise cookie which will contain a message and a band inside a cookie. And whenever somebody eats it, he gets a message that, okay, I miss you or anything. That's it.
There's a lot of fantastic ideas. Congratulations. I think it's probably all of us are hungry, so I'm not going to give a very long comment. But I like the idea that you're eating everything that's presented to you.